Hello everybody, my name is Phương Nhi. I continue my presentation by presenting to you about teaching skills. I will divide it into three parts, including introduction, issues, models, and activities. First of all, I have two questions for you. Question 1. What are the two skills in English teaching that will receive the language, understanding it and convert the meaning? So the answer is listening and reading. So I call listening and reading is receptive skills. And question number 2. I am delivering an oral presentation. Is it called receptive skills? No, it isn't. So an oral presentation relates to speaking and I call it productive skills. So productive skills are writing and speaking. Also known as active skills. Learners use the language to produce a message through speech or written text. So now, going to the next part, I need your help by cooperating with me to experience a language class, but not English, it's Spanish. Could you please repeat after me? Libro, libro. Huevo, huevo. Pelota, pelota. Silla, silla. Ever, ever. Flora, flora. So again, Libro, huevo, pelota, silla, ever, flor. Now you say them again. Do you remember all of the words? Probably not, right? I would like you to fill all the words I have just shown you into this reading gap filling test. Do you think that teacher provide enough vocabulary practice? Structures for students in Greek teaching. And my purpose to add this task is letting you recall your teaching time with English. You should think lower the level as your students. You should think of it, this is the first time your students see those new words. Even you teach higher level, your students haven't produced the new structure yet. And this is one of the issue in teaching a language. Teachers tend to focus on various activities because teaching practices in each stage is boring. Therefore, I hope you provide enough vocabularies and structure in reteaching in any skills. So that's my implication for this presentation. Now, I draw your attention to a basic methodology model for teaching receptive skills. To make it simple, I mentioned four main steps. They are leading, teacher directs comprehension tasks, student read or listen to the task, and teacher direct feedback. For leading, we can choose any of these tasks to impress students at the beginning, such as using multimedia, dialogue, having questions, hot topic, or storytelling. For comprehension tasks, we can use graphic of mind map, visualize some exercise types like true false or gap filling, multiple choice, role play or debate. Moving on, the model of teaching productive skills. We also have four main steps which are important, including leading, set the task, monitor the task, give feedback or related tasks. For leading, teacher monitor the for leading, we still have the activities like receptive skills. For set the task, teacher can have the variety of topics, various topics, cue cards, puzzle, sample writing, and worksheets. So in monitor the task, teacher moving around and help students. But don't forget to give feedback when your task finished and provide some related tasks if possible. So that's all about the content of my presentation. Please feel free to ask me any question about teaching skills right now. If you don't have, I could move on wrap up questions. Question 1. What are receptive skills and productive skills? So receptive skills are listening and reading, also known as basic skills.